From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. With some scary moments for a truck driver in Scarborough Wednesday afternoon. Police say the heat caused some power lines to sag on Parkway Drive low enough to snag on a passing truck. The lines came down, falling across the cab of the truck, trapping the driver inside. CMP crews were able to free him safely. And because of the incident, one pole has to be replaced. But no customers ever lost service. Investigators say the driver actually passed under those same lines several times earlier in the day without any problems. A Rumford man is in the hospital after crashing his car in Bethel Wednesday afternoon. Police say 51-year-old David Mason was headed south on Route 232 around 4:45 when he lost control of his vehicle while going around a corner and hit several trees. His car was totaled. Investigators say Mason was not wearing a seatbelt at the time of the crash. He was flown to Central Maine Medical Center in Lewiston with serious but non-life-threatening injuries. The cause of the crash is still under investigation, but police say it is possible Mason suffered from some sort of medical condition. A man serving a life sentence in prison for killing a 12-year-old girl back in 1988 pleaded not guilty Wednesday to felony drug charges. Dennis DeShane is accused of having morphine and an anti-anxiety drug at the Maine State Prison. He was rushed to the hospital back in April after prosecutors say he took the drugs and spent several weeks in the hospital. He is charged with trafficking in contraband, which means he had the drugs without a prescription. DeShane maintains his innocence in the death of Sarah Cherry and is seeking a new trial based on DNA evidence. An arbitrator has ruled on a dispute between a school district and a private school in York County. Both sides are calling the result a victory. After school consolidation happened, RSU 21, which includes Kennebunkport, and Arundel, had offered students in Arundel the chance to go to middle school in Kennebunk. But Thornton Academy and Saco claimed that violated their contract with Arundel. An arbitrator ruled 19 students who had already enrolled in Kennebunk could stay, but students other than those 19 could not sign up. RSU 21 has to pay $315,000 as a penalty. The relationship between Thornton Academy and Arundel may soon change for good. Folks in RSU 21 will vote on whether or not to terminate the contract with Thornton, and that would take effect in the 2011-2012 school year. Officials in Auburn are talking about turning a vacant building on Chestnut Street into a brand new community center geared toward offering rec programs for children. Police want to start by creating an organization designed to help raise funds for the rehab of the building. The proposed Police Activities League would not only act as a fundraiser, but would also work to coordinate programs with police officers and kids in the neighborhood. And thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.